Hey everyone, my name is Saahil Hussein. I'm from India. I'm an Indian medical student here at Jiangxi University of Chinese Medicine. Today, I am here at a place called as Jiangxi National Nature Reserve, which is located in Yichuan. And today, I'm very honored to join on a scientific investigation to see if we can actually find the Andrias here. It is said that a new species of Chinese giant salamander has been discovered here, which is called Andrias jiangxiensis. This is my friend Peng Yong. This is the head of Dachi Shan Protection and Administration Station here at Jiangxi Shan National Nature Reserve.
Yeah. 这样，我们所我的右手方向，所这里就是这个我们大吉山辖区的金家水系，这里的这个溪流里面呢，就是我们江西大里的野外的繁育的场所。
Peng told me that we are now in the Jinjia water basin of Dachi Shan Station. The stream next to us is the wild habitat for Andrias jiangxiensis population. Sir, how did you find this place? 大哥，你怎么发现了这个地方呢？
是这样的，在几年前呢，我与同事一起在夜观的时候呢，经常观测记录到娃娃鱼在水里游玩捕食的各种各样的场景。 中国科学院昆明动物研究所，江西省科学院和静安县农业农村局跟我们九鼎山一起合作的重点项目鄱阳湖流域三栖水系分布的大泥种质资源调查及保护创新研究课题组，经过近两年的调查，让治理的野生娃娃鱼不仅得到了有效的保护，还连续两年发现了野外的繁育场所，每年都有稳定的幼苗出生。 研究人员综合形态学和遗传分化证据将其描述为一个新的新种江西大鲵。So
Peng just told me that he and his colleagues often observed and recorded the Andrias outgrazing and playing around in the water during the night. A two-year cooperative project between Chinese Academy of Sciences and Jiangxi Academy of Science to investigate Andrias germplasm in Pouyang Lake Basin found their wild breeding places with newborn lives each year, laying the foundation for the protection of the wild Andrias jiangxiensis, a new species defined through morphological and genetic differentiation research. Sounds amazing. I cannot wait to get going. Let's go together.
来，我们一起去吧。好。哎，这个东西是什么呢？
What thing is this?
这是一套无线电追踪的设备，啊。 这个大鲵呢，它这个是夜行的。我们等一下呢，白天就要开展一个无线电的追踪，用于记录江西大鲵它在野外的如何的一个活动的轨迹。这套设备啊。Peng
brings a radio tracking device, and during the day we will be conducting field radio tracking of tagged Andrias. The main purpose of this work is to record their movements in the wild through long-term statistics. What is the general activity of Andrias? 大鲵是有什么特点呢？
大鲵它这个特点生物学特性非常明显，它是属于这个政府业出的夜行性动物。大鲵这一个呢，像它这个每年到了繁殖期之后啊，它这个雌性的排完了卵之后，剩下的呢就交给了雄性的个体。所以它这个每个长达几个月的繁殖期的时候，这个雄性的个体呢就负责孵化这些这个的蛋宝宝。所以我把它形容为雄性的大鲵为中国好爸爸。
Andrias jiangxiensis is a very miraculous nocturnal animal. During the breeding period, after the females have laid their spawns, the males are left to incubate and nurse their babies for several months. So Peng described the male Andrias as good Chinese fathers.
好，我们现在已经到河边了哈，我们要开始下水了。
Oh, Peng says that we have arrived to a place where he could find, Andrias here. 这个设备有什么作用呢？什么工作？This thing what you are carrying, what is the use of this?
这套无线电追踪设备呢，是通过那个发射的这个信号呢，这里接收到，然后呢，通过这个频率呢，慢慢去追踪它，追踪的这个距离大概有150到200米的距离，然后随着距离的靠近，它这个声段的这个声音呢就越来越小。你看现在我们距离还比较远，所以现在就听不到声音，你可以试一下看。
哦，
嗯，
我试一下。
啊，对。
现在没有声音啊！对对对，现在没有声音，听不到那个声音哈。嗯，那么我们就。So Peng says that this device works on the basis of radioactive waves. The radioactive waves catches the sounds of the movements of the Andrias, from 150 meters to 200 meters. So as soon as it catches the radioactive, catches the waves from this device, so we could find the movement and where the position of the Andrias really is. Mm.
Hey, 这个水好冷吧？这水好凉哈，好冰哈。对，好冰。啊，是啊。我们这里面是一个无人区，我们这个保护区里面是没有人员进来的啊，这里面是没有任何污染的这个水。像我们平时我们水就直接可以喝的。Oh,
so Peng, what he's saying that the water here is very pure. It's a pure form of water. It's near to the nature, and there is no mixture in this. So it can be drunk. So 我尝一下吧。可以啊，你尝一下。嗯，没问题。
哎，味道也不错啊，很甜的哈，很甜的。So
this water tastes very good, pretty good actually, very natural.
像我们这个江西大鲵这个物种，在这个溪流里面，它这个生存呢，它一个要有几个条件。第一，这个水的温度要低；第二，它这个含氧量要高；第三，它这个整个。 这个地方还有没有受到任何的这些污染？你否则的话，你这些受到污染的话，这个就会崩溃的。Oh,
so what Peng is saying that the place where we find Andrias, the place is very, you know, very clean, and the water there nearby to the Andrias are very pure without any mixture, as I said, you guys. In Jiangxi, particularly.
像我们有的时候啊，你包括在像这林子里面呢，经常都有那个猕猴 monkey。
Monkey
啊，对，哎，在这里，这跑来跑去。啊，今天我们找不到。哎，对，今天我们可能不一定碰得到，经常是那个背着小宝宝的肚子里面的这个抱着小宝宝的，一个家族一个家族在这里跳来跳去。
So Peng is saying that in some time, if we could have come, in other time we could have find any other, you know, monkeys here. He says there is a very cute family of monkey staying in this nearby forest. So I'm asking him if he has heard any, you know, waves or the noise. He says, not yet.
So
I'm trying to listen the sound of this Andrias. Eh?
Yeah.
有吧？有声音啊，有声音哈。应该是那个，也有这边附近的。哎，对，已经靠近来了哈。我们继续往前面走。好。So we could hear the sound. There is the signal. T T T. There's a beep sound. So we could. He says that there is just. It's just nearby somewhere. Where is
好，我这里这个信号越来越强来了哈，信号已经很靠近来了。
So he says that the sound is increasing now when we are going nearby to that. It must be somewhere near.
Hi. Hello. 是啊。嗯，根据我这里综合判断，我觉得。
So Peng says that the Andrias must be somewhere hiding nearby this rock. Wait, so I can hear the beep noise from this machine. 对, the sound is quite strong. I mean, it's more now.
根据我们的追踪判断，就应该就在这个石头下面。哎，好。这样了，我们为了这个判断它到底是不是在这里，我们一般呢是用一个这个内窥镜呢，去看看它是不是在里面生活的还健壮，一般是这样的情况。
Pang just told me that according to radio tracking, there is an Andrias Jiangxi species here. When we have tracked individual Andrias, we also use our endoscope equipment to observe if they're hiding in their burrows. So he says he cannot find it.
因为它这里面的它的石头是这样的，一层一层在叠起来，它里面就缝隙。这个大泥它个体非常柔软，它可以钻来钻去，钻来钻去。那么我们这个管子你就没办法顺着它的活动的轨迹。So
Feng says that we cannot track the movement of this Andrias from this device because it is hidden beneath this under this. Very few, I think, small rocks inside this very huge rock of this kind, and this kind of device, it's quite hard for us to you know, track its movement because this device cannot have that particular movement when it gets in under the rock.
Today we are very tired, so they usually hide in their burrows in the daytime. They don't come outside, so.
一般的时间是白天都在躲起来嘛。是的。哦。哎，这个大泥呢，它是这个水中的最大的两栖动物啊。它是白天呢，它一般都躲在这个洞穴里面，这个是这个洞里面啊，树洞里面。所以说，我每次来这个追踪的时候，虽然我们能够追踪到它的哪个位置，因为它洞穴里面太复杂了，所以我每次通过这个探洞的设备呢，就不是说每次都能够探得到它。
So what Pang is saying is that in the daytime they hide in the burrows, and usually they hide inside the burrows. They won't come outside. So usually when he comes here, he has to carry this endoscopic device to come and find it where they are. And sometimes he could find it, but sometimes they are hidden. Okay, well, we have actually filmed how the team and the colleagues have, you know, tracked this Andrias the night before. Let us have a look at the short video now.
我在这里工作已7个年头了，感觉这里的动植物就像我的亲人和朋友一样。我们大姐三藏主要的工作有生态保护、科研监测、科普宣教、社区共建等林子里每一个地方都留下了我们的足迹。哎，这个凳子全部都捡起，对吧？今晚我的要开那个动物调查。啊，那是一只非常足迹哈，在那里休息，在那睡觉。这棵动物的生物学特性呢，它都喜欢站在绿色这样的树丫子上睡觉啊，这样的树丫子呢是它休息的一个场所。对它们来说，这样睡觉是属于最安全的。啊，再往上走，这是一只雌性的黄金，看到没有？
这条鱼，这个光纯。好，我们到哪边？到那边去。啊，对，到那边去。以前遇见过的。
好，你看我这个已经扫出来了，33、06。嗯，好的，嗯，刚好现在刚刚就马上就称体重。 嗯，900，我们今天晚上这位大尼，江西大尼哈，他这个是已经是属于我们是属于重普的，已经的，我们通过扫码 GPIT 已经标记扫到他那个尾数是306吧？对，啊 ，PIT 标记的哈，啊，那么今天这个就作为我们一个重普的一个记录啊，我们今天呢就把这个大尼呢测一下他的体重啊，测一下他的体长。 然后回去跟我们数据核对一下，看看它在这段时间里面有没有什么长长或者怎么样或者啊啊移动，嗯嗯，还有它一个活动的轨迹啊，好，42，嗯，这个可以打个比喻啊，可以相当于这个。 高一高二的学生来了，江西大尼跟其他大尼这个从形态上面，一我们这个野外的不跟那个养殖场里面的哈，其实它的很臃肿啊，你看它这个头型呢都是很优美的，更扁平。另外一个它这个第三趾它这个脚趾啊，比其他的脚趾要更长啊。如果我们遇上了新个体，那么我们就要有对它进行剪起点分子，啊分子样哈，然后要做好这个 PIT 标记，打好坐标点，是吧？好，嗯。那这样呢，我们这个就放回了。嗯，好。刚刚是在这个位置哈。那好，我们现在要就地放回了，原地。嗯。好。 马上找到石头缝里面钻进去了。我们长期的在野外啊，经常这样的，每个月要开展这种野外的这个监测，也正是因为我们长期以来，一直这样的积累下来这些数据啊，提供了这最基原始的一些数据之后呢，才得出这江西大尼这样一个结论。
Welcome back to the short video. Now we have learned more about the scientific research of about Andrias. But now I want to ask a question. What is the long-term significance of protecting these wild animals? 那现在我想问一下一个问题：为什么我们要保护这样的一个大尼嘛？有什么重要的？是这样的，江西大尼呢是我国首个遗传身份明确且野外稳定繁殖的大尼纯种种群，也是我国首个可记录大尼完整智能生活史的野外种群。纯种江西大尼的发现。 为我国大尼的保护带来了希望，以此为基础，进一步在全国范围内开展一系列的野外调查呢，有望能发现更多类似的纯种野生群体。在此基础上，采取科学有效的保护措施呢，就能够避免一些物种在被描述前就走向了灭绝。I see. Pang just said that named Andrias jiangxiensis. It is the only known species of Chinese giant salamander in China with a genetically pure. Reproducing in situ population. The discovery of Andrias jiangxiensis has raised hopes for the conservation of the Chinese giant salamanders. Based on this, further systematic field surveys across the country are expected to uncover more similar wild populations, on which scientific and effective conservation measures can be taken to prevent some species from going extinct before they are described. In my opinion, biodiversity keeps the earth alive and the humankind. Protecting the biodiversity preserves the earth and sustainable development. Thank you for watching our live stream. See you again next time.